So we talk about how you make this more real for people. How do you take something that's so esoteric as pulling carbon out of the air with basically a giant vacuum cleaner and putting it safely and securely deep underground? It's not a balloon. It's actually going into rocks just like this. When you talk about how you make things real and how you bring this to life for people, what do you find most effective?
You know, and when I'm talking to sort of like the general public, you know, analogies are really helpful because it is so abstract. And so understanding the idea of like, we're just gonna take CO2 direct out of the air that we're breathing right now, very understanding, they get that. How to do it, I think, you know, the idea of a filter is very effective in the same way that like a Brita filter potentially in your fridge works by filtering out whatever sort of constituents are in your water. It's the same idea, we're just filtering out CO2. And then once we filtered out the CO2, you know, when you put it underground, I think the best analogy is a sponge. You can think of rocks, although we see them as these sort of hard physical substances, which they are, the way CO2 interacts with it is much more like water into a sponge. You know, when you take a sponge and you wring it out, what then happens to the CO2 in this analogy? And I say, yeah, now imagine you buried a sponge 8,000 feet underground, and you've got that much earth on top of it. The water is just not going to go back up. That's just not how physics work. And so I think through using analogies that people can really grapple with, it's effective.